I'll stand here and I'll say the same thing that I've said for the last several years, and eventually you guys are going to understand it, that I will never and never have put the record ahead of what the team is trying to accomplish. But there again, the record would be great for me. I happen to be probably the only player that will ever have a chance of breaking that record. But it's not the utmost thing in my career, in my life. I mean, I won't jump off the bridge if I don't get the record. We're just grown-ups playing a kid's game. And if you can continue to play it with the enthusiasm of a kid, and there again, it's a little harder here than most places right now, because when you're some 19 games under 500, you have to really dig down to bust your tail. And that shows a lot of character from people when they can play hard, when they know they're not going to the playoffs. Hell, it's easy for the Cubs to play hard tomorrow. They got a little bit of a lead in the East, and they're anticipating the playoffs. I said it before, and I'll say it again. There's no player in the league that if he plays a game the way it's supposed to be played, when September comes around, he's going to be tired. I don't care who he is. If you play the game day in and day out the way you're supposed to play it, you're going to be tired in September. But fortunately for me, I can't remember the last time that I went into September and didn't have a chance of going to the playoffs. And because of having that chance, I didn't think about how fatigued I was, because I didn't have time to think about it. I had to be thinking about batting practice in preparation for the upcoming games. I don't know if there's any manager in baseball that knows as much baseball as I do. You can only know so much about baseball. I mean, I just had to understand my personnel and know who to bring in at the right time. But there again, a manager is as good as his players. But a manager has to get the players to give him 110% every day.